So, I'd like to tell you the story of my experience in life, and it's brought me to be able to work at the UNC HIV Cure Center. When I started medical school, the very first summer I started medical school, an event happened in Los Angeles that we came to know as AIDS. And as I went through my medical training, we encountered many patients with AIDS. We learned that it was caused by the HIV virus. And in the beginning of the pandemic that soon emerged throughout the world, all of our patients died. But by using science to improve medicine, we were able to develop antiretroviral therapy, which eventually was able to completely stop the growth of the virus in infected people and return them to health. This had a remarkable impact on HIV, and it was a remarkable experience to go through, not having to go to funerals anymore. So the chance of dying from AIDS went from certain to almost nothing. With the use of now a single pill that contains three medications you can take once a day, these medications will get somewhat better, somewhat easier, but it's really pretty remarkable. So we went from many, many deaths and the AIDS quilt, which was more than 10 years ago, too big to even fit the wall in Washington, to a new paradigm where we need to find people with infection, try to prevent infection, and get them into treatment so we can restore their health. So this is a great thing, but there's still a lot of advances that we need to prevent infection, prevent the spread, continued spread of the pandemic. And there was a great idea had by Mike Cohen at UNC more than 10 years ago, the idea of using therapy not necessarily to treat the infected person, but to prevent the spread. And over a 10-year struggle, he directed a study of thousands of people across the world that showed that this strategy was essentially 100% effective. So this led to our current wonderful but challenging situation. We need to treat everyone with HIV infection, both for their health and to reduce the effect of the pandemic on the world. So this presents a challenge because there are now millions of people that will need chronic medical therapy for decades. And so this has led to the idea that maybe we need another approach, curing HIV. But there's another reason to want to cure HIV, and that's the reason for the patient. The burden of living with HIV is a heavy one. And so how would we do this goal of curing HIV? When patients are on treatment, essentially there's no active replicating virus in them. There's only latent-beginning virus. This is a rare form of infection in a few cells, but it's invisible to drugs and invisible to the immune system. So at the Cure Center and in other places, we're looking to develop anti-latency therapy to drive the virus out of hiding, sort of opposite of what you would expect, so that we can then employ immunotherapies kill the residual infection, resulting, we hope, in a cure. So we can move from the paradigm of having available therapies to take people out of the infected population and move towards a better world, one that is absent